All right, welcome to another Speed Shop. We're filming the intro and the outro at the same time today. So we're gonna go around the room and just say what we're riding on this ride. So Jack, what are you riding?
2002 MXZ 800.
MXZ 800. Greg, what do you got?
1990 Formula Plus 500.
Sweet. Dave, you're
I'm driving a Focus. I'm the sport group.
Awesome.
Yep.
I got an 01 XD 600.
Yeah, that is Tim at Precision Pumps.
Yes.
So there you go. There's the intro.
Thank you. still.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The outro. So did anybody actually fall off their sled today?
Nope.
All right, it was a pretty good ride overall, I thought.
Awesome ride.
I mean, the trails were brutal. I mean, holy crap.
But we were riding.
We were riding, and riding is better than sitting at home. So I don't know what else to say. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks to the patrons. Like, share, subscribe. All that yep. stuff.
And the focus guy. And drink beer.
And the focus guy.
And the focus guy.
Just thought I'd give you a little quick walk around on the sled I rode in this video in case you're new to the channel. So, this is my 1983 Cross Country Indy. It was actually the first sled I built on the channel. I love it. I went all through it. Redid all the bearings and such. You can see I've got the gold rails on there. She's still got the original round trailing arms, which I like a lot. She's midnight blue and gold, which is cool. The seat is the same as the Indy 600 seat. So Indy 600 in 83 was black. This was midnight blue. And still got an original gold windshield on it. Somewhat battered, but I'm going with it. Under the hood, we have what appears to be your basic TXL motor, but it's actually an SLP 404 big bore, and there's even a video in that series on how to tell that. I'm running K&Ns on here, so if you notice it sounded a little different than the 81 TXL, it's probably because the 81 has an airbox, this has K&Ns. Maybe there's some subtle difference in the Indy exhaust, I don't know. I did do a top loader brake upgrade to it. I love having a dipstick to check my chain case level, but otherwise, She's mostly stock. Well, mostly. She's got the modern, brand new P85 on her. And, you know, she's clutch for excitement. So, comes in about 5,000 RPMs. I'm pretty happy with that. So, all in all, I love this sled. It's a great sled to ride. Oh, yeah, and it's got a lightning bolt 7/8 tall track on it. So, good sled. But I rode the heck out of this thing last winter and started riding it this winter. And I think it might be time to pull it in the shop and maybe do a little maintenance. I don't know. I think we're heading to maintenance week here. I think I got a lot of sled maintenance to do. So anyways, just thought I'd stick this on at the end of the video in case you weren't familiar with what I'm riding. And by all means, go back and watch the build series on this thing.